In this video, we want to go over and cover the Autopilot tab within the control panel. Now, this is not meant to be a complete lesson on the Autopilot. This is just an overview. There are complete lessons on the when you purchase the Autopilot in the Autopilot plugin education center. So this is just a quick overview of the Autopilot, just to kind of give you a heads up and an idea of where things are and how it works. And I want to go down through it very quickly and just show you some of the highlighted features. Now, the first thing you'll see across the top is the Autopilot settings and a Q-Calc. You'll see a row of Q-Calcs down the right-hand side. You'll also see a system setup. This control panel, or this Autopilot, was designed to allow users or traders to be able to trade and to create auto trading systems without requiring you to be a computer programmer. We've programmed in behind the scenes all the capabilities necessary to set up an auto trading system, and then you just select through click and drag and the selection system and process here of the selections of the things you want the Autopilot to do. So now what we do is we come in, and this, of course, the first section here is the system setup. This is where you save the different settings or save the different settings of your control panel or of your Autopilot that you might have. You might have two or three or four different settings, and you'd save those here with new, save, and delete. This is the indicator that you might want to use when you are trading, and you'll notice that we have two indicators turned on currently. We have the bulls and bears, and we have the MACD. And so the MACD is the one that's showing in the list here. We also have the bulls and bears in there. We have a Q-Calc button next to the indicator, which of course goes through, and Q stands for quick, and the calc is to automatically calculate the best settings for that indicator based on the settings in the control panel. Now again, I'm not going to go through every one of these, but you'll notice it is broken down into three different sections. The first one is the system setup section. This is where you're going to do your trading quantity, your time frame restraints, and that type of stuff. We have the entry strategy. This is how we're going to get into the market. This is where we go through and we set up again, select the different types of entry strategies, whether we want to make that a market order or a stop order or a limit order. We have different thrust bar signal preventers, so if markets move too far too fast, we have those types of filters to help you not get into markets that are too active or into markets that are inactive. We also have trend capabilities to go in on both long trends or just short trends or multiple trends. And so those things, again, are covered in greater detail in the Autopilot Plugin Education Center. We also have the exit strategy. This section right here tells you how we're going to get out of the market. So as you can see, what we do is we have very simply put in here the system, which system you're going to use, how we're going to enter the market, and how we're going to exit the market, how we're going to take our profits. And so this is a very simple control panel, again, allowing you to go through and set this up so that you, as a trader, can have an auto trading system that'll automatically have track and trade go through and place orders for you, manage the trades for you without having to be a computer programmer. Now we can also do back testing. We can come back and test our system and see how accurate it's been over time. And I'm going to raise this accounting window back up again like this. And you'll see down here, this is the control panel, and I'm going to come in, I'm going to click on this section here where we're into the accounting. You can see the accounting of the different trades, and then this is the Autopilot button, and this is how we get into the Autopilot section. So when this pulls up, initially you may see it like this. It's Autopilot, pending orders, open orders, closed orders. We want to click the Autopilot button, and this is where we come in, and this is where we have a chart that indicates how accurate our trading system is. It gives us some of the statistics. Let's come in and use a more preferred indicator. This is currently going off of the MACD. Let's come in here just for fun and put it on our bulls and bears system. Ah, that's a little better looking. And so we're going to come in here, and we have a number of ways of coming through and actually reviewing the different trades that it's made and the way it's working. This particular example, we got 174 trades, 95 of them round turns, 54% winning ratio, repeated wins. We have 6 repeated wins in a row. And you'll notice we have a number of different statistics across here. Again, I'm not going to go through every one of those. They're covered in greater detail in another place. But we can come in and we can customize this the details that we have in here by right-clicking on the header, say column setup, and you'll notice that we have a dialog box that pops up, and you can choose any different type of format or information that you want to be displayed in that window for you. And if you not exactly sure what something means, and notice that these are hyperlinks, and you can simply come in here and say, what does it mean when we say profit factor? So you can click on that and it pops up and gives you a detailed description of what profit factor means and what good profit factors are and what bad ones are. We hit OK, and you can add that profit factor into your list if that's what you would like to see. And then we say OK, and that's what gives us our statistics across this window here. You'll also notice that we have initial balance. We start off with an initial balance. This is for our back testing, however many fees, and of course here in the Forex market there are no fees because we're working off of a spread. The start analytical date, the time, the end date, and the time, and whether you want it to set the day automatically based on the time frame of the current market, and then to have it automatically recalc as you change different settings within the window. And so that's a little overview of this particular window. When we're ready to start trading, we can come in here and very simply click the Start Trading tab, a button, and you'll notice it'll come up. Of course, we have some disclaimers in here. I accept the terms, and I say OK. And you'll notice that the track and trade draws a green line of where it has taken over now and begin trading, taking over the trading based on the settings that we have here in the autopilot window and based on the historical data that we've accumulated.